All right. I am going to play Lost Civilization by Jaska or Jaska. This is a 9-map WOD. It used to be 8 maps. I played it several months ago. Some of them have been shuffled around and some of them have changed completely. And I'm going to play map 2. It's called Mountain Village, I believe. That's the one he suggested I play. All the maps in this WOD, from what I played, are great. So we're going to give this a go. This is GZ Doom on Hurt Me Plenty, Jaska's Lost Civilization, Map 2, Mountain Village. Start on a boat. Right away you can tell that visual detailing is priority in these maps. And it's great. It's great throughout. I just can't get enough of it. A lot of exploring to do as well. Now, there didn't seem to be a MIDI. I loaded this up a minute ago and there was like no MIDI at all, so I'm playing Pathos by Darkest Hour, which is really a... like a metalcore band. However you want to classify them. They're pretty brutal normally, but this is an acoustic instrumental track. Rocket launcher. Yeah, he changes the sound effects for his shotgun and chain gun. I'm pretty sure shotgun too. Which is really not my favorite thing, actually. I don't really like the sounds. But hey. If that's the worst part of the whole WOD, and it probably is, to be honest, then you've got a pretty good map set. And some people like it, I'm sure. Should have gotten that first. Yeah. So here's a little bit of a teaching moment. If there's any new map makers watching this, there's a blur artifact over here, and there's a bunch of hit scanners here, and that's what you want. You don't want a blur artifact when all you have to deal with are predictable projectile monsters. Oh, I forgot I have the double. Yeah, you want a blur artifact when you've got hit scanners, primarily. Even revenants sometimes. Yeah, as you can see, the detailing, the visual design is just great. I picked up the red key. It's also in such a way that it's not easy to get lost, I don't think. You know, you've got different areas. You've got this beach area, you've got this huge cliff mountain thing that will end up going up. You've got this city area with these staircases, so you've got landmarks. Jaska said that he got rid of the original opener, the original map 1, which, if I remember correctly, was great looking. But the one thing about that map was it wasn't as distinct looking in different areas, so it was a little bit easier to get lost. And perhaps that's why that one got cut. I guess a little bit of a misalignment there. We'll forgive that in such a nice looking map. there's health. Health is good. And stuff. Got cacodemons just roaming around freely. That looks like it hurts. But I will go exploring. I mean, I could just, like, stare at this map. I don't even need to shoot anything. The combat is not bad. I mean, as much attention as there is in the visual detailing, the combat could be awful and I'd still play it. But the combat's pretty good. Oh, there's a berserk. I gotta remember that. I'm not gonna get it now because I have all my health. Yeah, I already got a rocket launcher, so what Jaska is keeping in mind is that in a wide open map, people are going to play it in different ways. There's lots of different paths. There's no correct path, maybe not even an expected path. So it's a good idea to have the weapons, not just the ammo, but the weapons in different places. There's another rocket launcher. I'm not the biggest fan of door textures that don't really open, but at least these are not traditional door textures. You know, they're not like Big Door 1 or anything like that. Seem to be lagging just a little bit here. Hopefully that goes away. Because I don't remember that problem before. Of course, I'm also recording this. Wait, there was... Yeah, nice to be able to go up on the rooftop and have a nice view of, like, the whole map here. How far can I go? Ooh, there's a pool over there. I want to go in that pool. Where's the pool? Alright, now I can go get that berserk. Yeah, I do remember this level. Did I mention that already? But I think I came down these stairs near the beginning, so I'm thinking that he changed the player's start. Actually, yeah, I remember coming all the way down this water path. And that actually looks like the original map 1, because he does this thing where the exit of the map is like the start of the next map, so he's got the smooth transition. Okay, this is probably gonna be my exit here. Yep, there's another rocket launcher. Alright, so I got the red key, and I need yellow for there, and then I'll get blue, and then I'll be able to exit. So I already know basically what my objectives are, which is good in a wide open map with a lot to explore. So I think I probably gotta go over there now. Or is there something else over here? Yeah, let's go over here now and try to find this cliff. I better save it here. That's what this is called, right? Oh, this is a lot of... Wow, 359 enemies. Is that what that said? Oh, 259. 9 secrets. Well, I'm at 11% on that regard. I wonder if there's something good over here. Oh. Oh, I don't want to go down there. Okay. Oh no. Oh, I thought I was going all the way down. Ammo's a little bit tight, but it's not too bad. Mission. Find health. I kind of like free-roaming lost souls without a pain elemental. You know, they can just run around and wreak some havoc. But there's not an infinite, potentially infinite source of them, at least. That might be it. As far as health. Oh, there we go. Alright, that'll be good. Might be all there is. Could use some more bullets too, but hey. Alright, let's try this again. Don't you just love the visuals here? You get another big view of, like, the whole map. He goes. Goodbye. Okay. Nice cave area here. I do like the sky too. It's very plain, but I like it. There's the LPD. I don't know, ammo. Alright, so I guess now I can either go all the way back down or dive off. Ooh, what's this? It's a secret. We like secrets. It's another rocket launcher. This. Oh. Whoa. Incubus somewhere. Huh. Ooh. Oh. Well, there's a plasma gun. I want that. There's a plasma gun. Plasma is... Oh! And a soul sphere. I love secrets. Alright, so there's yellow. So what am I at now? Alright, I got 4 secrets. I remember being lousy at secrets last time I played through this whole map, or this whole wad. Like, I never got soul spheres or plasma guns. Hey, you guys can fight each other a little bit. The secrets are kind of hidden in plain sight. And they appear to be kind of duplicate, because I saw another plasma gun on a ledge. Which I think works, because maybe you don't expect the player to find all the secrets, because it's kind of... there's so much to explore, and you want to reward the player for finding just some of them. So you make some of them kind of the same thing. Four out of nine is not bad. I always consider it respectable when I can find half the secrets. Oh, I'm not gonna bother trying to kill that imp over there. Alright, so, yeah, once I get that last key, I'm conveniently over here, which is where I need to go. Here's my all three keys door. Oh, the plasma's changed too. I guess I'm just a sucker for the old school sounds. Okay, two more enemies. I know there's one over there. Yeah, he tends to do the exits by just having you... they're not always obvious. You just kind of walk, and then, like, map 4 is going to start exactly like this. Or exactly like this. Yeah, so the exit's there. Just take a quick look. Yeah, wonderful map. We'll go ahead and finish. Yeah, not much more to say. Great map. Play this map set. Do it.